He's pre-read like 100 times so far. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I feel like you need a new catchphrase.
Povert?
I feel like you're going in the wrong direction there.
Poopvert.
Still going in the wrong direction.
Brevere?
Just stick with pre-read.
See this guy? You got to know when home. I feel like 36 experience makes a weird amount.
Well, it's 10% off 50.
It's 36?
Hey, no, it's not.
Yeah.
Yeah, why is it doing that? Wait a second.
Yeah, because there's something else that's affecting it. What's all this dust all about?
Dust in the wind. All we are is dust in the wind.
What was that song written about Princess Diana?
What?
What was that song that was written by Princess Diana? By Elton John?
By Candle?
It was four.
Well, originally,
Candle in the Wind.
It was originally for Marilyn Monroe.
Really?
Yeah, he changed the lyrics. To die. Really bad.
Yeah, I don't know these things.
That's why you're coming to the number one Elton John podcast. Let's
Dude,
play.
Here's the deal.
Are you mad about me constantly saying podcast? Well, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Because then it kind of advertises the podcast, Bob. But here's the deal. If we're famous enough to get the rights to do the Elton John podcast, I will do it in a heartbeat. I don't know enough about him, but I'll learn it, man. That sounds awesome. Here's the thing about him. He lives every day to the hilt. He's having fun. He does what he wants.
Well, I mean, he has enough money to do what he wants, let's be honest.
Okay, but when he was getting that money, he was doing what he wanted. He's like the Lady Gaga of men. Think about how true that is.
No, I would say that Lady Gaga is the Elton John of women.
But, well, yeah, but if we had to do it reverse, then yeah. You
but
couldn't
no,
say chronologically. I know chronologically that is the that of that, but generally that is the that of that.
Yeah, okay, but that's...
Thank you. I know I'm right. It's a dumb analogy.
Learn and live.
Just because I make the... God.
This is Mitzi Gaynor. During wartime, quick and accurate information is best for the public. Conrad, radio broadcast...
I need an automatic weapon.
...will be your only official means of information.
That was a shot.
In an attack, tune to 640 or 1240.
Oh, dude, I was hearing about runs people do. Like, goofy runs people do.
Okay.
The one that was suggested is, at character creation, you think of one word, and if the NPC you talk to, or if you talk to an NPC and they use it, you have to kill them. That's really funny to me. That's kind of a good idea. If I'd known about it, I would have done it.
Welcome to Jacobstown, human.
Guys, I'm going to show you a little trick to this part in a second, too. Is it really Worf?
Yeah, it's Michael Dorn.
San Francisco. Anyway, I'm going to show you a little trick to this part, which a few people might know. Is that a sentence? I'll show you in a minute. Just don't even worry about it for now.
Okay.
You know it. But it's a thing. When you see it, you'll say, yeah, of course I know that. Who doesn't know this? But the listener doesn't. They're Fallout veterans, and they don't know it.
I guess we'll find out.
Also, give me that. Jonah got lost in the belly of a crazy whale. A calamity.
I'd heard...
That's great. Do you, for some reason, sell things? I'll take 24 of those stim packs.
I'm still waiting for this magnificent secret.
Dude, I think I told you before. You're gonna be like, that's the greatest secret of all time. If you say that, I'll be so happy.
I guess we'll have to wait for it.
Thanks.
You're like... You may say that, too. Okay, what do you think is the most valuable thing we've purchased? The suite, recording interface, the microphones, or the hop pad?
Well, seeing as these things that we can all associate a cost to, the word valuable, obviously would entail it's the recording thing.
You're saying because it costs the most?
Yeah.
Got a problem.
Okay, here's how this works, guys.
Also, he totally body checked.
I know, he always
does. Boom!
They just showed up again.
So this is the easiest thing to do. So this guy's chilling out. You gotta go talk to this guy who loves life. Who's living. Living, love, a libelob. Timmy Libelob. This guy wants to talk about it.
Our business is with the muties.
So you have a speech check here, but then you don't do it.
We're still owed half.
Then you get him to give him your money.
So this is what you do if you're a real bastard who wants to steal money from a innocent town.
What do I care? It never matters ever. One of the endings is that they didn't have enough money, so they all died. Then the key is you lie here.
Damn it. That'll wipe out the town treasury.
That's 3,000 bucks. Then you get a bad karma, which you can easily undo by shooting a million slugs in the face or something. And you walk back to this guy who's gonna be like, I love money, I'm a mercenary. Well, if you try to fight these guys, for some reason it's NCR stuff, which bothers me.
What?
And you do a speech check.
They're hired by the NCR. He even says it.
My men and I are leaving.
Boom. Then you just made $3,000 doing absolutely nothing. Because you certainly don't have to return it. That's what I used to do when I wanted to get in the strip really fast. Is I would just do a circle around. And then I would just go here and then come back.
Something on your mind? Good. Glad. Defense.
See, again, it's a real dick move. Colors to it. You're stealing money from innocent people for no good reason. You gave me so much crap for when I freaking wanted to have innocent people defend their homeland, and you just straight up stole money for people for literally no reason. Straight up stole money. At least
we can all agree that submutants are not people, and they are less than human.
They're more than human. They're super mutants.
Okay, the mutant is lower than human.
Well, I'd say they're at least on par with humans.
Listen, you know my opinion towards ghouls.
They're great.
No, I absolutely will not tolerate ghouls. It's like
Dude, we got ourselves a little enclave over here, it seems.
Everyone knows that ghouls are fools, and they need to be killed. No one... Hand loader we're taking.
Oh, yeah, it's a good choice.
No, I don't suffer ghouls. In 3, I didn't let him live. In this game, there are no ghouls, so I don't have to worry about it. There's seriously no ghouls in this game.
Yeah, it's really low.
You got, like, a couple of friendly ghouls who you're not going to kill. Okay, let's list all the great ghouls. Desmond, he's great.
Dean Domino.
Dean Domino is one of my favorite characters in the game, despite being ghoul.
I don't know what your problem with ghouls is.
I feel like it's fun to have a little bit of speciesism when it comes to playing these games. Kind of helps you roleplay a little bit. Also because the feral ghouls are my favorite thing to kill. In addition...
But the other guys aren't feral.
Well, they could become. Not in a gameplay sense, but in a lore sense. And since I'm roleplaying as my character, sort of... I know that I wouldn't be too quick to trust something that become a terrible monster killer. So this is what you can do if you have...
The majestic mountains.
You don't have walls on. Just climb this here mountain. It's like Oblivion in this bee. You walk over here. And then bam! Here's the whole world. You're just chilling out. You walk along. And you see, eventually, a bunch of dudes to kill. By dudes, I mean cazadores. And by seeing...
continue?